us is a king's burden. A king must make decisions. Lesser men are neither willing nor able to make. A king is indeed presented with quandaries lesser men might never encounter in the course of their whole lives.
Life for a man isn't easy. We've been spoon-fed this idea that all men are dogs, all men are replaceable. We don't need them. Men are no longer the leaders. Instead, they should take a back seat. Away with all your masculinity, they say. Away with all your aggression and stoicism. What you need to be is more soft, submissive. Reject your natural vigor. Embrace your emotions. It's wild, they say. You know, don't ever look at a woman as just a slab of meat. But at the same time, you sure can pay $20 to see her topless on her OnlyFans. These days we're told, put away your chivalry. A woman is just as capable to open the door for herself. She can pay for her own meal. She can provide. She can do anything a man can do. But the second a drunkard comes by and happens to mess with her, who's she looking to now? If a crazy man comes in with a gun, who's gonna put themselves in the firing lane to protect her? It's wild. We're told a woman doesn't need a traditional man to take care of her. But the second she's in danger, that old traditional man be looking real good now, right? Look, my brothers. We can no longer look to culture for our standards. We gotta look to God, to tradition, to the ways of old. See, every man is called to lead. He's called to be a king. But not in a tyrannical, abusive manner, but instead in a serving, sacrificial manner. A man should always be willing to lay down his life for his queen. He should be willing to do chivalrous acts. There's nothing shameful about embracing your masculinity and leading a family. There's nothing shameful about having a traditional wife who submits to you, who looks to you in complete awe, who looks to you as the man. But with that headship comes great responsibility. You've got to earn your seat on the throne. Many men these days want the authority, but without the duty. They want to rule like a king, but only want the responsibility of a child. And this is because modern times continuously offers us the easy way out. There's a quick fix for everything. If things don't go as planned, that's okay. Just give up. Move on to something new. If your relationship starts to get a little bumpy, if you and your girl aren't getting along, that's okay. Rather than staying devoted and working through the tough times, just log on to your dating app and swipe away till you find something new, fun, and more exciting. Rather than changing your lifestyle and becoming more healthy, just pop that pill that the doctor prescribed. That's way easier. Rather than getting your life together financially, just wait till that next stimulus check. Look, my brothers, all these things the world offers, yeah, it might seem nice now. Yeah, it might make you happy momentarily. But if you choose the easy route, if you choose to immerse yourself into pleasure, entertainment, all the instant gratifications that the world has to offer, life will eventually catch up to you. Every decision you've ever made, good or bad, will ripple through the years. The more you avoid failure, the more of a failure you will become. The more you avoid hardship, the more harder your life will become. The more you avoid any kind of discomfort, the more uncomfortable your life will eventually become. This is an all-out war that we are living in. But not the kind of war you think. This isn't a war with guns and artillery. This isn't chemical or nuclear warfare. This is a war to take control, to take out the head, to dethrone the king. And just like the story of Adam and Eve, the snake has slithered his way into our homes. So we've got to stand guard, my brothers. Just like the great kings of old, the mightiest kings were not the tyrants. They were warriors and servants. They led the soldiers to the battlefield. They were on the forefronts. They were willing to die for their people. And that needs to be our mission. You need to choose. Will you dam up or man up? Don't embrace the trends of modernism. See, the modern man is weak. He's self-centered. So as a man, the choice is yours. Today, you can either choose to lie, or you can choose to be honest. To have good friends, or to have bad ones. You can choose to watch Netflix, or to read a book. To play video games, or to work out. To watch porn, or you can choose to remain mission focused. You can continue to build and work on yourself till you find the right woman. The type of woman who you can raise kids with, build an empire with. You can choose pleasure today, or you can choose purpose. See, deep down, every single man, every single one of us wants to level up. But be very mindful of the make-believe achievements that the world offers you. Don't allow hookup culture to tell you that the more women you have, the more masculine you are. Don't allow prawn to corrupt your mind and tell you what a mighty, powerful king you've become. Don't allow all these video games to tell you you're a winner and you should feel accomplished. Do not allow these pretend fantasy achievements to confuse your mind for real progression. The Bible says, choose this day whom you will serve. So who will you serve? Will you serve the world? Yourself? Your flesh? Look, there's no more time to flirt with the enemy. There's no more time to have one foot in and one foot out. It's time to wake up. Come back from the dead. Choose to serve a higher purpose. Choose to serve Christ. And remember, my brothers, this video will not set you free. That self-improvement book will not set you free. Buying a program or joining a Discord will not set you free. Your choices will set you free. And every day we are faced with hundreds of different choices. Some big, some small, but not one of them is insignificant. Each one will either lead you into becoming a stronger man or a weaker one. Now I believe you are stronger than you realize. I believe 110% without a doubt you are called to more. If you have breath in your lungs right now, that only means God has some unfinished business for you. He's got plans for you to prosper you. He's orchestrating a family for you, a wife for you. He's already forming your future children. He's connecting you with the right people. Right now, he has intentionally placed me before you. He's speaking to you right now, and he wants you to know it's time to break free. If you don't want to be like most modern men, you have to ignore most modern advice. Don't fall for the false doctrine that your innate desires as a man are bad. Don't fall for the false lies that you are incapable or not worthy. God says you are fearfully and wonderfully made. Remember, it doesn't take any courage to be normal. So embrace your masculinity. Embrace your aggression. Remove the distractions that are keeping you from who you want to be, who God's called you to be. Do not remain complacent any longer. Complacency is just a playground for the enemy to mess with you, to play with you. The enemy loves complacent men. Because in this state, a man will always remain ineffective. He remains not a threat. So for you watching this, deep down, I know you want to live up to your potential. I know you want to level up. I know this because while everyone else logged off and grabbed their phone to go swipe their life away on TikTok, you're still here. You've invested your attention, and now the scales have fallen from your eyes. So what will you do now? If you want to join a tribe of like-minded individuals and join a team who you know has your best interest at heart, make sure to subscribe to this channel. I post around 4 videos a week. With that said, it's time to rise, my brothers. It's time that the enemy has been defeated. And the only way we can win is if we collectively come together as an army and fight back. Fight for tradition. Fight for godliness. Fight for true masculinity and what it means to serve your family.